but it was a hook that did it. Boom! Right there. Money in the bank all day.
We just witnessed one of the biggest fights in boxing this year. From Garcia promising a first round knockout to actually making Haney wobble in the first round with his speed and power. It seems that Haney didn't have the power for a knockout in the beginning of the fight, and Garcia seemed to have quite the energy too, till things took a turn in round 7. And finally, Ryan took the win.
Congratulations. Coming into this fight, I think it's safe to say that no one believed you could win. We saw the odds go against you 600, 700, 800 to 1.
Which has left many pros talking. Even Haney himself was unimpressed. Let's catch you up. Now remember, Canelo had predicted Ryan winning, and he also had something to comment on after the fight. Canelo Alvarez, the undisputed super middleweight king, isn't known for mincing words. That was a war. I told everyone Ryan could win this if he was focused, and man, did he show up focused. Those knockdowns, especially the one in the 7th, brutal. You saw the doubt cloud Haney's eyes after that. Canelo, a master tactician in the ring, also appreciated Haney's focus. He acknowledged how Haney wasn't fooled by just the highlight reel knockdowns. He also acknowledged how Haney clawed his way back in there. He took the punches, even controlled the fight for some stretches. But Garcia's explosiveness was a constant threat. He truly channeled that laser focus I talked about before the fight. While impressed by Garcia's power, Canelo isn't also shying away from pointing out areas for improvement. Always a proponent of fighters showing heart, Canelo would also acknowledge Haney's grit. You gotta give Haney credit for his toughness. He was rattled after those knockdowns, but he never quit. That championship experience, that composure, it helped him weather the storm. With a future-oriented mindset, Canelo also predicted what's next for the division. This fight just blew the lightweight division wide open. Rematch? That seems like the obvious route. If Garcia can tighten up his training, stay laser-focused like tonight, he becomes a real force. But let's be clear. Haney will be back with a vengeance, ready to adjust his strategy. This comes after Garcia was just asked if he would like to do a rematch, and his words, "Let's run it up again," just added to his confidence.
Ryan beat Devin, in your opinion, Canelo, if he's okay, like mentally?
If he's 100%, yes.
Man, I don't know, man. I gotta gather my thoughts. At the end of the day, I need a shot of beer, like alcohol, something to get my mind going, feel me?
But it wasn't just Canelo's words. Mike Tyson has been following this fight up close, and he wasn't left behind on the line of comments. He even showed up before the fight to wish Ryan success. Now, as a former professional boxer and undisputed world heavyweight champion, Mike Tyson has seen his fair share of intense fights. But the bout between Garcia and Devin Haney was something else. In this game, it's all about the heart and the will to win. Garcia showed that tonight. It was a great fight, Tyson added. Tyson seems particularly impressed with Garcia's performance in the first round. And let's be honest, we all were. Garcia came out swinging, and he made Haney wobble. That's a sign of a fighter who's come prepared, who's done his homework. He knew exactly what he was doing, and he executed it perfectly. The 7th round was another highlight for Tyson. Garcia gave Haney a 3-combination knockdown. That's not easy to do. It takes skill, precision, and timing. Garcia had all 3 tonight. Tyson, just like Canelo, also noted Haney's exhaustion. And we all could notice that Haney seemed to be running out of steam. And according to Tyson, that's the thing about boxing. It's not just a physical game, it's a mental one too. You've got to pace yourself, conserve your energy. It looked like Haney was struggling with that. Despite Haney ruling the 9th round, Tyson felt that Garcia dominated the 10th. Garcia came back strong in the 10th round. He'd already given Haney 2 knockdowns by then, and he wasn't showing any signs of slowing down. The 11th round was the clincher for Garcia. In Tyson's view, the 11th round is what showed him that Garcia had this in the bag. He was relentless, and he kept pushing until the very end. According to Tyson's comments, the fight was proof of Garcia's skill and determination. Garcia showed us what he's made of tonight. He's a fighter through and through, and he's got a bright future ahead of him. Tyson's final words were about the sport itself, adding that boxing is a tough game. It's brutal, it's unforgiving, but it's also incredibly rewarding. Tonight, We saw two fighters give it their all in the ring, and that's what this sport is all about.
This is why people need to stop believing everything on the internet and stop, you know, living in a false reality. At the end of the day, there's a lot of real shit going on. You know, the last thing you should worry about is a kid acting crazy on the internet. Real shit is going on in the world. Open your eyes.
Look good, bro.
Thank you. Thank you.
You been eating bricks?
Yes. I'm going to eat them today.
You look beautiful, bro.
Thank you. Love you. Love you,
Nate Diaz, a seasoned fighter and respected figure in the combat sports world, also had some insightful comments about the fight. Known for his straight shooting style, Diaz didn't hold back in his analysis. Everyone thought Garcia was off his rocker, but he proved them wrong tonight. He's not crazy, he's just a warrior. This extended Garcia's comments from after the fight, where Garcia told everyone, "You really thought I was crazy." Then going on about how he just proved everyone wrong. And now, from the focus we just saw on Ryan Garcia's side, we believe him now. Diaz was referring to the widespread speculation about Garcia's mental health. People were saying that Ryan needed mental help, but what they don't understand is that this is a tough sport. It takes a toll on you, mentally and physically, but that doesn't mean you're crazy. It just means you're human, and a little mind games is not that bad. Diaz went on to analyze the fight, expressing his admiration for Garcia's performance. Garcia was on fire tonight. He made Haney do a little chicken dance in the first round, and then he gave him a three combination knockdown in the seventh. That's not something you see every day. Just like everyone else, Diaz also commented on Haney's exhaustion. Haney looked like he was struggling out there, but that's part of the game. You've got to know how to pace yourself, how to conserve your energy. It's not just about throwing punches, it's about strategy. Despite Haney ruling the ninth round, Diaz felt that Garcia dominated most of the match. Garcia came back strong in the 10th round. He'd already given Haney two knockdowns by then, and he wasn't showing any signs of slowing down. Well, to be honest, the 11th round had everyone talking, and this includes Diaz too. Diaz appreciated Garcia's push, gave a thumbs up to Garcia for making his opponent dance and sit in the ring, and even went on ahead to say that Garcia has it in him. In Diaz's view, the fight was proof of Garcia's skill and determination. From making everyone think he was mad to making a comeback in the ring. And let's be honest, this is sports. And whatever you do in the ring is the only thing that matters. According to Diaz, Ryan Garcia wasn't all talk. He did what he said he would do. Win the match, and that's exactly what happened.
Them 3 pounds. We knew he was going to come in heavy. We knew he was going to come in heavy, and it cost him. That's two. That's three.
Now let's look at Terrence Crawford's words, who has been waiting for this fight as much as we have been. Terrence Crawford, known for his remarkable achievements as a three-weight world champion and his status as one of the best pound-for-pound fighters globally, provided his unique and insightful analysis on the Garcia versus Devin Haney bout. Crawford really admired Garcia's performance, saying he's not just a regular contender, but a strong fighter in the ring. Just like the others, Crawford has praised Garcia's focus and determination during the fight, pointing out how sharp and in control he was, showing he's got what it takes to be a real champion. Crawford has also added on how Garcia stayed cool even when things got tough, showing he's tough and has a strong competitive spirit. Which again led him to pointing out that Garcia's head seems to be in the game, unlike what many people believed was true. Anyway, we're all glad the fight wasn't canceled, and Garcia has also shown that it was not worth canceling it. To add to that, Crawford has expressed optimism regarding Garcia's future trajectory in boxing, citing his youth, talent, and hunger for success as key ingredients for a promising career ahead. He sees Garcia's potential shooting to greater heights if he continues to exhibit the same level of dedication and skill he just showed. Perhaps one area that has been left out by the others, where Crawford touched on, was his admiration for Garcia's signature left hook, praising its speed, power, and precision. He has observed how Garcia's left hook caught Haney off guard, adding praise to its effectiveness as a huge weapon in Garcia's arsenal. It's always that left hook, Haney knew it, but didn't even see them left hooks coming. Crawford also commended Garcia's performance in the first round, highlighting his agility, footwork, and strategic approach in setting the tone for the fight. The intensity and momentum Garcia brought to the opening exchanges showcased his readiness to engage and impose his will on his opponent. The 11th round knockdown also didn't leave Crawford silent. According to Crawford, it was a big moment that further showed Garcia's dominance in the bout. Garcia's precision and timing in delivering a decisive blow that sent Haney to the canvas signaled a turning point, solidifying Garcia's control and ultimately sealing his victory. Now, let's get to the biggest comment after the fight from the opponent himself, Devin Haney. While Haney displayed his characteristic control with a sharp jab, Garcia's explosive power proved decisive. The fight went the full distance, with two judges scoring it 114, 110 and 115, 109 in Garcia's favor, while the remaining judge saw it a 112. 112 draw. Garcia acknowledged the pressure he faced, but emphasized his dedication. "I put my F King reputation on the line," he declared before calling for a rematch. The thrilling fight featured multiple knockdowns of Haney by Garcia, showcasing the Californian's raw talent. Haney, undefeated prior to this fight, expressed disappointment with his performance but remained composed.
"The glory, I couldn't do it without you. I love you so much. Come on, God, you really thought I was crazy?"
He acknowledged his vulnerability to Garcia's left hook and highlighted his ability to recover from adversity. "I would love a rematch," he stated, emphasizing the closeness of the fight. Interestingly, Haney pointed out that Garcia missed weight for the bout, suggesting he remained the true champion. The result not only marked Garcia's return to the spotlight, but also shattered Haney's undefeated record.
"The fight, I was more surprised than hurt. The first time I wasn't really that hurt. I was more surprised. Like I said, he went in there, he jumped on me, just like he knew he would, but I was just sleeping."
Their rivalry, which began in their amateur days, where they split wins 3-3, has reignited with a new chapter. With both fighters calling for a rematch, the boxing world eagerly anticipates a potential second encounter to settle the score definitively. What do you think about the fight? Share your thoughts below and hit that like and subscribe button for more updates. See you in the next one.